I'm Melanie Windridge. I'm a physicist, speaker, writer, and I like to mix science with adventure. I've always liked skiing and hiking and getting outdoors. And I became interested in the Arctic and in polar exploration, and I wanted to visit these places. And I'm a plasma physicist, and so I thought, well, I should see the Northern Lights. That's an incredible plasma phenomenon. I should really see this. So I became interested in that side of things as well, and I liked it because in fusion the physics is very lab based, whereas with the Northern Lights I could still look at the physics, but I could be in a completely different environment, a wonderful, beautiful, incredible environment. And so that's what started me writing the book Aurora, because I just wanted to visit these places, and then I realized that there was so much more than just the science. There's the people and the landscapes and the stories, and so that drew me in, and that's what ended up as my book Aurora. It's a mixture of all these things. So sometime in 2013, I think I was putting it together, and as a plan of what I could write about, how it could be a book. And that 2013 was also the time that I first saw the Northern Lights. So up in Kiruna in northern Sweden in February, I had my first experience of the Northern Lights. And even at that time, I was thinking, maybe I could write a book. And then I committed to it, you could say, at the end of 2013. And so through 2014, 2015, I did several trips. So I went to like Iceland and Canada in summer, learned a lot about the research that was going on up there, also walked a popular trekking route in Iceland, learning about the geology of the landscape. And then in 2015, I went to Svalbard, which is a small Norwegian archipelago. It's really high up in the Arctic. It's about halfway to the North Pole from the north of Norway. So it's really far north. And I really wanted to experience the aurora in a wilderness environment, in the way that the old polar explorers would have done. Science and exploration have huge parallels. In fact, I think that basic scientific research, as in fundamental scientific research, is an exploration in itself. And so that's why I think there are huge parallels. Exploration is, by definition, stepping out into the unknown, doing something that no one's ever done before, and it teaches us so much. And scientific research is exactly the same. Like, we're doing things here that nobody's ever done before. We're trying things, we're really stepping out into the unknown. So I think that fundamental science is a form of exploration, and so I'm really interested in science and exploration, or rather innovation and exploration, and how they drive each other, because I do think they drive each other. It's like a cycle, and science is part of that cycle. I think that humans have an innate curiosity. We have an innate drive to step out into the unknown, to explore, and that's what drives our human progress. So to me, it's very interesting, that interplay.